FastAPI with Python, deploy to Google Cloud. So this is an introduction to how to get your app onto Google Cloud so that you can expose it to the World Wide Web. These are the steps you'll need to go through. First, you'll need to sign up for Google Cloud Trial. If you've got a Google email address already, then it's not too difficult. You will need to provide your bank details, however, or credit card details. They promise not to charge you, and you can also set an alert when you get close to using up your credit and rolling over onto the payment, but they say they won't charge you without informing you. So sign up for the trial, create a project in Google Cloud Console. So pretty much everything you do within Google Cloud Console requires creating a project. So top left, project, create. I'm not going to go into that here. There's plenty of information on the Google Cloud documentation. Next, create a virtual environment for your code. So if you're going to deploy to Google Cloud, you need to actually have a pristine installation. So if you're interested, there will be plenty of information about doing that. Go to python.org, venv. This is the correct way to do it. So Python 3, Python M, then venv, and then path to new virtual environment. Once you've gone there, then don't forget to do source and activate and so on. So there we go. Depending on what platform you're on, Windows, Linux, etc. So once you've created your virtual environment, you're going to then want to install all of the modules that you're going to be using. So you'll need to install FastAPI, obviously, and NLTK if you're following along with this project and the previous two videos. You'll need to install UVicorn or GUnicorn. Right, then the interesting bit, which is writing your actual code, which you've seen in the previous videos, hopefully. If not, I'll put the link here somewhere. What you need to do is basically write the code and call it main.py. So if you've got more than one file, that's fine. Just write it as if you're doing a standard, a normal Python project. Next, you need to create a YAML file and a requirements file, or instead of YAML, you could create a Docker file. It's entirely up to you. To do this, I actually used the YAML file, and you'll see coming up shortly, you'll see how I did that. Once you've done that, you'll need to deploy either from VS Code, if you've installed the Google Cloud extension for VS Code, or you can go to Google Cloud Console and then actually do it from the command line there with the gcloud commands. So everything in the terminal shell within Google Cloud, you'll need to do gcloud init. If you haven't already installed the software development kit, you'll need to do that first. So install the SDK, so plenty of instructions out there. Once you've installed the SDK, then go to the console and then do gcloud init, and then you can follow all of the documentation with the gcloud set project, gcloud app deploy, and so on. Really, this is an overview. I don't want to really go down into all the nitty-gritty, because that's not the point of this video. This is really for someone who's got some awareness of Google Cloud and Python and just wants a quick overview on how to pretty much get it set up. So next, deploy to Google Cloud Platform, either from VS Code or Cloud Console. Obviously, once you deployed it, then test it. So these are the three files. This is kind of the MVP, minimum viable project. App YAML, main.py, requirements.txt. Requirements.txt you can create using pip freeze greater than sign requirements.txt. Obviously, do that once you've installed all of your relevant packages. So you'll have installed NLTK, you'll have installed FastAPI, and so on. Again, using pip. This is a screenshot from the Cloud Shell editor within Google Cloud. So if you choose not to use VS Code, then you can do it all from Cloud Shell editor. And again, this is a screenshot from my successful installation. So I transferred the files onto the Google Cloud platform. How did I do that? Well, I created a repo on GitHub and then I did git clone. So I cloned my repo onto the Google Cloud Shell platform. And for that, you can just use git clone. Just be aware that anything you install on the Cloud Shell editor is basically running on a Ubuntu VM and it's ephemeral, so you'll lose anything that you install at the end of the session. When I say lose, you won't lose your files, but you would lose any any things such as Git and so on. Right, requirements.txt, NLTK, UVCorn, FastAPI, Pydantic, which is important for this project, and GUnicorn. I don't know if I actually needed to have both there, but in the end, I installed both and it worked. So there we go. That's the requirements.txt as of December the 8th, 2021. Now, the app.yaml, I had a little bit of issue with that, but in the end, I got runtime colon Python 3.7, entry point, and then GUnicorn hyphen W4. Hopefully you can see that it's a bit dark in the red. Hyphen K uvcorn.workers.uvcornworker space and then main colon app. So main needs to match the name of your Python file. So if your Python file was called my Python file, then it would say my Python file colon app. Okay, so assuming you've registered for Google Cloud and you've created a project, then you can follow these steps. So it's gcloud init to basically initialize Google Cloud's command line. Then gcloud's config set project ID. You can do, once you've got gcloud installed on the command line, from the command line, you can run gcloud projects list. And then that will give you the list of your projects. And then you just choose one using gcloud config set project followed by the project ID. Once you've done all that, then gcloud app deploy app.yaml. And again, this is what I did and it worked. So I'm not saying you have to do it this way, but this is a successful method. You wait a while it installs and eventually it will give you a message which says something like deployed service 2. And then you see the URL which it deploys it to. So that's your project name and then it's followed by .nw.r.appspot.com. And to view your application in the browser, run gcloud app browse. There. And when you test it, for instance, if you copied my code, you'll get an error when you try and test it in the browser because that's using the get method. And obviously the code that I wrote uses post. So if you get this though, it means you've got a successful installation. It just means you're not accessing it correctly. And this is I'm going to show you two screenshots here. First one here is a successful test just using a very short and sweet Python script with import requests. And I'm passing user data as JSON to this URL, which you see the /predict. And if you remember in the code, /predict was actually one of our routes or routes if you're in the US. Sentiment positive. So testing it in the browser didn't work because it was using get, but if you use this script, it will use post, as you can see I've highlighted there in yellow. And again, second screenshot, and this time I've said not so great. And NLTK Vader has worked out that it's negative sentiment, which is the whole point of this project, sentiment analysis. Obviously, you'd probably want to write a front end for this, which can be, you can do that however you wish. And method not allowed. That was because, why was that? Oh, sorry. Yeah, in the background there, I'm showing method not allowed. That was from when I was trying to access through the browser. And there we're just doing another example with not so great. And then we get sentiment equals negative. So hopefully that's been a quick whistle stop tour of how to successfully deploy a Python app to Google Cloud. If you've got any questions, then drop them in the comments. Really, this was an overview. I didn't want to kind of go deep into the nitty gritty because there's different ways of doing this. You can either use VS Code, Google Cloud, you can use the console. You could use Git clone, you could use wget. There's various different permutations, but really the focus of this was actually just to make sure that you know or understand how simple it is really, because you just need the requirements.txt and the app.yaml. I wanted to show that this was very minimalist to get it up and working, and obviously you can then embellish it from there on. So thanks for watching. Hopefully this has been a good follow-up to previous two videos. They're not intended to be in-depth. They really are kind of overview, get started. And really it's the kind of video that I wanted to see when I was looking around and I didn't find really, because just wanted to have a nice overview, and there we go. So thanks for watching.